Hi, it's Jennifer Hollick again with the World War II Research and Writing Center in the Livingston County War Museum in Pontiac, Illinois. Now we are on our third interview of the day, and I'm with John Hamilton, who has 34 years in the Army, and he served during the Korean War also. So I'd like to thank you for talking with me this morning.
Jennifer, thank you. It's my pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And a lot of people, I've been focusing on World War I, World War II for the last decade, and I'm just now moving into Korea and Vietnam, and I have some clients now that are starting to look into their father or grandfather or uncle's service. But I don't think a lot of people really understand the service during the Korean War, how some of our guys served in World War II and then went into Korea, and what happened. So when you joined the military, were you drafted? Did you enlist? How did you get started in the military and then end up in Korea?
Well, it's rather a long story. I was in high school, and my senior year I joined the Illinois National Guard. Mm-hmm. Then the Korean War started, and our unit was activated for the war, and that's how I became involved.
Okay.
Starting the very beginning, I guess. I went to Fort Benning, Georgia, the infantry school, mm-hmm. to become an officer. I came out a second lieutenant infantry. It's a rather challenging job. You lead infantry troops in combat. Somewhat hazardous.
Mm-hmm.
I did because I wanted to, and I'm glad I did. I would do it again. I was young then. When you're young, nothing can happen to you.
Right.
As you get older and have a little more experience, I'm human, I can get killed too. I have many memories of that. I guess the best place to start in the very beginning, I went to Fort Benning, Georgia, the infantry school.
Mm-hmm.
I made it through, came out as second lieutenant infantry. 6 months troop duty with the troops, then home on leave, and over to Korea. My first assignment, I was a brand new second lieutenant, young, clean shaven, starch uniform. My platoon, my first sergeant introduced me. You're dirty, scroungy, beat up, combat veteran, the best. I was a new boss.
Mm-hmm.
That is a challenging experience, trust me. I had two things going for me. Had a platoon sergeant who was outstanding. Wasn't for him, I would not be here today. And somewhere along the way, I was told, lead by example.
Mm-hmm.
You lead by example, they will follow you. It works. My first night online was an experience. I was a new officer, new guy, and all of them are tough, hardened veterans. And I was their boss. The first night we got hit pretty hard. We had one killed, one KIA, two WIA wounded in action. The next morning, we got things quieted down. Platoon sergeant comes and said, "Well, Lieutenant, we broke in the right way, didn't we?" I said, "You sure heck did." And after that, I was always scared. I don't know what other people are, but I was always scared. But as I controlled fear, I could function and do my job, yet I still had nerves.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I think they call it combat hardened, and I was. I got through it after that first night pretty well. It was typical hand combat, front lines, north. It was North Korean Chinese, south side was us. And we fought back and forth. Things were reasonably quiet, and I wouldn't say quiet, but not unusual, till Outpost Harry. Outpost Harry was a hill in the center of the Cherwan Valley. We owned it, the Chinese wanted it, we didn't give it to them. In a few words, that's what happened. The night of 10 June, 2200 hours, they hit us. And they hit us hard. Our orders were to hold at all costs. You don't that's rather unusual to get receive an order like that. Normally have you can maneuver and so forth. Here you will not. You will hold this piece of terrain. You will not give it up. We didn't give it up. We held. It was rather expensive, but we did it. We made it. After about 1 week, they finally gave up. We destroyed an entire Chinese division. Our regiment did. There was dead bodies everywhere. It's true combat. It's tough. But we held. The 3rd Division held. I was extremely proud to be a member of the 3rd Division. We held. After that, things kind of calmed down a bit until toward the end of the war. Then the Chinese broke through the Chorwan up at Kumwan. The Capitol Rock Division got hit hard. They retreated. That's a good way to say it, I guess. We're just pulling offline. We're ordered to go forward, hold at all costs. Here we go again. So we got up, got online, and we held. It was touch and go, but I was online the night the war ended. Never forget it. We got the word, war was going to end 2,200 hours that date, whatever it was in July. And I didn't believe it. It happened. At 10 p.m., mingle, ceasefire. That was it. The war was over. I could not sleep at night. It was too quiet. I couldn't sleep. Darndest feeling I ever had. I rotated home about a few weeks later. I had my points and everything. I rotated home. And we own farmland, so I farmed with my dad for a few years. And it's good life. I just wasn't ready for it. So I went back into military full-time with the Army National Guard in 1960. And I stayed there. I got my 27 years in, and I'm pretty happy. Ended up full colonel, I guess it wasn't too bad.
Mm-hmm.
And I retired in 1980, got out, became a certified general appraiser, appraised farmland. I was doing that till I had the stroke a few years ago, and now I'm retired.
Mm-hmm.
That's basically my military career. I can fill in a lot of the details. Also during that period, I was commandant of the Military Academy. I was in charge of the OCS NCO school. Pretty important job because we were responsible for the future mm-hmm. of the Guard. I enjoyed it. It was very good. Also during there, we had riots. In the 60s, a lot of riots. That's miserable because you're up against Americans. Mm-hmm. We're Americans. But do you have a job to do? And that's exactly what you do. And we controlled it.
Mm-hmm.
The Chicago riots were pretty bad. But we got things under control, and you will have law and order, and by God, we enforced it. There's law and order. I had a lot of good experiences in the military. I liked it. I really liked it. I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I would do it over again.
Despite everything, you would do it over
again? Yeah, I'd do it over again. I would do it over again, yeah. It was a bad moment. The reason I think I'd say that, I went back to Korea a few years ago. When I was there the first time, utter destruction, nothing. I came back, in fact, I went on a tour about a month ago of Korea. You cannot believe it. It's day and night. Their technology is better than ours. They're more advanced than we are.
Wow.
It's utterly amazing. They're very hard-working, industrious people, and they are good, mm-hmm. very good. They have done extremely well. I saw it before I went through there in 1953, I remember, flat, nothing. Now it's a beautiful city, mm-hmm. better than Chicago. It really is. It's amazing what they have done. So people ask me, was it worth it? Yes. I lost some very close friends, but it was worth it because people are free.
Mm-hmm.
It worked. It was worth it. Oh, so many other things in my military career. I'm trying to think, what all I did now. You name what I did. I was air defense for some time. That was challenging. I went from infantry to a missile unit. That's fun.
Really?
Yeah. That's a joke. I would get up at 4 in the morning to crack the books because I was infantry, that was electronics, and I made it.
Mm-hmm.
But I studied pretty hard to do it. Nights I did other things. Won't go into any detail, but had a good time. Morning at 4 o'clock, I hit those books, I made it.
Mm-hmm.
And air defense was a big deal then. Because it was the Russian threat, well, still the Russian threat, but they were afraid they were going to bomb us, aircraft. And we had missile units. I was in the Chicago Gary Defense. Our mission was defend the city in case of an attack.
Mm-hmm.
And to do that, you had to be on your toes at all times. They had OREs, Operational Redundancy Evaluation Teams, come in day or night. Come at midnight, in helicopter, whatever, and you better be ready to fire in a matter of minutes. Very stressful.
I can imagine.
As well it should have been, but it was challenging. I had the pure good fortune. I got the battery. I went to missile school with another officer, he's a full colonel at the time, and a good tennis player. We played tennis a lot. I would make sure you won. You know. And when we got back on site, said, I got a unit here. It's the lowest in the defense, but I'll let you try it if you want it. Why not? I did. It was the ultimate challenge. They were good people, low morale. They did not believe in themselves. They couldn't, sloppy, didn't look like soldiers. We changed that real fast.
Mm-hmm.
We got them where they were the best, and they were the only unit to ever fire at 100%. We have the record for the only unit ever to have 100% score, perfect score. They were good people. It wasn't me, it was them. They were good. And after we did the missile unit, they phased out. I came back downstate to Illinois to command staff, that sort of thing. My final assignment was Commandant of the Army National Guard Military Academy, ran the OCS NCO school. That was the future of the military. I really liked it, it was fun. And in a matter of a few minutes, that's my career. You got any questions or anything?
Well, I think, what lessons would you like the younger people to know before we wrap up? Are there things?
Work hard.
Work hard.
Work very hard. If you're going to be a leader, you will lead by example. That's a given. Mm-hmm. If you lead by example, people will follow you. Mm-hmm. If you say, go up that hill, I'm going to stay back here. It's not going to happen. You must lead, and they will follow. That mm-hmm. It works. That's my main advice I can give to any junior leaders. Lead by example.
Mm-hmm.
Work hard, set a good example. People always look at their superiors. If you're always properly dressed, do the right thing, they follow you.
Mm-hmm.
That's very your appearance, your attitude, your conduct. All that is very important mm-hmm. to a leader. And in infantry, combat arms, yes, leadership is extremely important.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the main things I can tell you about my career.
Well, thank you so much for talking with us.
My pleasure.
And we will be back after lunch, probably with a few more interviews, so check us out later. Bye.